Hello and a warm welcome to everyone to this session in remembrance of poet and writer Kokkare Hosahalli Sheikh Haider Nisar Ahmad in collaboration with Toto Funds the Arts. Toto Funds the Arts, or TFA, is a non-profit trust set up in 2004 to nurture and encourage young artists in India through workshops to add to their skills, discussions with and talks by eminent artists, literature and poetry events, theatre productions, and also awards for writers, photographers, filmmakers and musicians under 30 years of age. We are fortunate to have with us a panel such as this to remember and talk about K.S. Nisar Ahmad. In this tribute, S.R. Ramakrishna is in conversation with Nataraj Hulyar, who evaluates Nisar Ahmad's place in modern Kannada literature, Muhammad Ismail, who speaks about the poet's life and times, and M.D. Pallavi, who sings some of his songs and speaks about the impact his album Nityotsava had on the Kannada identity and the Sugama Sangeeta genre. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel and to our mailing list. Follow us on our Facebook, Twitter and Instagram accounts to stay informed on our upcoming events and more of such illuminating conversation.
Thank you, Bangalore International Center and Toto Funds the Arts for this opportunity to discuss poet K.S. Nisar Ahmad. So Nisar Ahmad was born in 1936 in Devanahalli, which is very close to Bangalore. It's also the place where Tipu Sultan was born and the place where we now have our international airport. Nisar Ahmad then moved to Bangalore for his schooling, and he was he spent a lot of his childhood days near Lal Bagh, you know, near and he studied near Chikmawali, which is close to Lal Bagh. Nisar Ahmad wrote poetry in many styles, and he also translated Neruda and Shakespeare. He wrote literary criticism for children, and but the one song that made him a household name in Karnataka was Nityotsava. Nityotsava is a poem about what he loved about Karnataka, the land, the trees, the mountains, and its antiquity, its inscriptions, and most of all, its generosity of spirit. So may I ask Pallavi, who's one of our most well-known exponents of the Sugama Sangeeta genre, to begin with Nityotsava, because music is a good way to start anything.
Thank you. Namaste, Nataraj ji, and namaste, Ismail ji. And thank you, Ram. I'm really honored to be a part of this remembrance of Nisar Ahmad. And Nityotsava was the album probably which kind of made him a household name across Karnataka, but also gave the genre of Sugama Sangeeta the popularity that it's seen today. That was the beginning of it, I guess. There were, of course, P. Kaling Rao and many other singers had been singing for many years, but this Nityotsava album kind of established Sugama Sangeeta as a very, very popular genre of music in Karnataka. And this is one of the most popular songs, even today, across Karnataka. Composed by Mysore Anantaswamy and written by Nisar Ahmad. And apparently he wrote this ode to the land when he saw the Jog Falls. So this is, it starts with the describing the beauty of the Jog. ಜೋಗದ ಸಿರಿ ಬೆಳಕಿನಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಗೆಯ ತೆನೆ ಬಳುಕಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಹ್ಯಾದ್ರಿಯ ಲೋಹದ ದಿರವು ತುಂಗದ ನಿಲುಕಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಿತ್ಯ ಹರಿದ್ವರ್ಣವನದ ತೇಗ ಗಂಧ ತರುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ತಾಯಿ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ನಿನಗೆ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ತಾಯಿ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ಜೋಗದ ಸಿರಿ ಬೆಳಕಿನಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಗೆಯ ತೆನೆ ಬಳುಕಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಹ್ಯಾದ್ರಿಯ ಲೋಹದದಿರವು ತುಂಗದ ನಿಲುಕಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಿತ್ಯ ಹರಿದ್ವರ್ಣವನದ ತೇಗ ಗಂಧ ತರುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ತಾಯಿ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ಇತಿಹಾಸದ ಹಿಮಗಲ್ಲಿನ ಸಿಂಹಾಸನ ಮಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಗತ ಸಾಹಸ ಸಾರುತ್ತಿರುವ ಶಾಸನಗಳ ಸಾಲಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇತಿಹಾಸದ ಹಿಮದಲ್ಲಿನ ಸಿಂಹಾಸನ ಮಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಗತ ಸಾಹಸ ಸಾರುತ್ತಿರುವ ಶಾಸನಗಳ ಸಾಲಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಓಲೆಗರಿಯ ಸಿರಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ದೇಗುಲಗಳ ಭಿತ್ತಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ತಾಯಿ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ನಿನಗೆ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ತಾಯಿ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ.
Thank you, Pallavi, for this lovely song. I think he wrote this sometime in the 70s. Nisaram wrote Nityotsava in the 70s, but his first poetry collection, Manasu Gandhi Bazaru, came out in 1960. And he had already made a name as a modernist poet, who was inspired by the modernist Navya movement. My question is to Nataraj. Nataraj Hulyar, the well-known literary critic, poet, and he's recently written a novel. Nataraj, he wrote Manasu Gandhi Bazaru in 1960, and then he had to contend with a host of brilliant writers of his time. Where would you place Nisar Ahmed in contemporary Kannada literature, and what would you say is his contribution to the world of letters, and how do you regard him as a poet?
See, when I listen to Pallavi, the Nityotsava, which Nisar wrote in the 70s, I suddenly felt it was an attempt to annihilate himself, as a modernist poet. Because when Nisar started writing in the 60s, Kannada poetry was in a transitory period. It was moving away from the lyrical mode. And also the rhetorical kind of poetics of the Pragatishila mode. And poetry was moving towards the colloquial mode, towards the speech rhythm. In fact, Navya's, Nisar was also part of this Navya school. Navya's rejected the poetic diction and started believing that poetry was more of a felt thought than a spontaneous overflow. So Nisar had to find his own voice, hailing from Devanahalli, and I suppose his mother tongue was not also Kannada. And most of the Navi writers who were writing then were English professors or Kannada professors who'd teach, literature, brief literature, and practice literature. Nisar was trained in, geology, and had an advantage because he was not always engaged, with literature, and that gave a kind of freshness to, Nisar's voice. By then, Adiga had set the tone of modernist poetry, and Adiga was excavating the past while Kambar was there. Kambar was also excavating the Desi past, and K.S. Narasimhaswamy was experimenting with the spoken rhythm, and Lankesh was there. So that is where, Nisar had to find his own voice. Avaru speech rhythm ge hatra bandru Nisar Ahmedu. Amele ondu middle class bhashe illittu adanna poetry ge taradakke avaru prayatna madidru. So that, jothege, Nisar was experimenting with his language also. He was coining verbs out of nouns. Pratijnege pratijnisunta madibidoru Nisar. And as you mentioned, when he wrote Manasu Gandhi Bazaru, it struck everybody because of the freshness of the imagery, which was there. And Nisar also tried to stand apart from other poets because he had a larger political understanding of the happenings of the world. In fact, I was looking at this poem, America. These are the two metaphors which Gandhinagar stole from Nisar Ahmed later. America is later made into a film, with the same title by Nagtheli Chandrasekhar. And then the episode of Kurigalu Sar Kurigalu made into a film later. I just read a stanza from America. This is in Kannada. America. There are two Americas before Nisar. Nina samskrutiya nagase kettidagella ninnavara tie suit skirt galana ondonde kalachi nettarininda Spanish ra Germanara Portuguese Angla Negro gala kadalgalla hantaka hadaragittiya nettetti ninnediru nooki pakapakane nagabekindaga. When the narrator is about to laugh at America, suddenly enagutte avige Lincoln, Kennedy, Kingara cheharegala kandu nudiyedivi kai mugidu beppagagutteni. So he tried to juxtapose two different Americas in this in a poem, and then came the famous Kurigalu Sar Kurigalu. Which in fact much before Nityotsava was a household name, Kurigalu Sar Kurigalu I think established Nisar's name among the non-literary audience also, though the literary literary critics didn't take it seriously. That made him popular among the non-literary kind of readers. So, by the time he, went to Nityotsava, as I said, he was trying to annihilate this self and was trying to, become something else, I suppose. I think there was a shift in his poetics. So that is where I think we may have to discuss, Nisar's position, because he was trying to strike a balance between the Navya mode and the Navodaya mode of Kuvempu and Bembre. And the split, sometimes the split helped him, and sometimes, it was not to his advantage. But Nisar definitely has a very significant place in the Kannada poetry, because he Navya Kalada Sandarbhadalli Naitu Oduguru Dura Hogta Idru, readers were moving away from poetry. It is to the credit of Nisar, he brought poetry closer to the ordinary, readers of poetry, because he was using the speech rhythm, in his poetry, and it was immediate and it was political, and he was trying to bring in lots of contemporary, instances into, his poetry. And one important, difference we see, when in case of Nisar, compared to other Navya poets, most of them were introspective, introvert. But Nisar tried to make it more of a general kind, moving away from the introvert nature of the Navya poetry. So Nisar definitely will have a place in Kannada literary history, because he made even serious poetry popular, readable, reachable, and communicative.
You're saying Nisar came from a unique position because he was not a teacher of literature like most of the other poets of the time, most of his contemporaries. He came from a geology background. He was an MSc in geology, and he was teaching geology in colleges in Shumaga and elsewhere. So before we go on to his themes, you have actually referred to some of the thematic elements that came into his poetry and that actually brought poetry back from being just an academic exercise to being more of a community exercise, where people were able to relate to poetry all over again. And you spoke about how he turned words like pratigne into pratignisu, gumani padu or santosha padu would become gumanisu or santoshisu, And he is also credited with creating words like slummiga for a slum dweller. I think these are very inventive ways of using language. Sort of very daring way of using language. And I would now like to ask Ismail. Ismail is. Was a journalist till recently and used to write a column on digital media in Prajavani. And he now works in an entertainment television channel. Ismail, you had the opportunity to talk to Nisar Ahmad over the decades. You've interviewed him several times, for many publications, and you also recorded his audio and put out a podcast. Now, what do you think about the way he was inventive with the language, the way he used words that others hadn't ever imagined, thought of? And what are your impressions of Nisar, and what do you remember of him?
Very interesting about Nisar Ahmed is that, you know, so his background. So though you see, all of us say that, you know, he born in Devanahalli, but his connection with Devanahalli is very less, you know. He's almost always in, he's actually from the place called Mavali, actually. He's not a Devanahalli Nisar Ahmed, he's a Mavali Nisar Ahmed, basically. So that is one thing. And another thing is, you know, his father is a government employee, and he has consciously put his son into a Kannada medium instead of a Urdu medium. As in, you know, as it's a practice in Bangalore Muslims, you know, normally the Muslim boy goes to Kannada medium, Urdu medium school. But instead of that, you know, his father has consciously thought that, you know, my son want to be in a Kannada medium school. That itself changes so many things in his life. And, you know, all these words, because, you know, he encountered a different world in that way. Because where he lived in Mavali is also very interesting. That's a Muslim-dominated place. At the same time, you know, it's also a Brahmin-dominated place. So those are the interesting things which happened in his childhood. And, you know, obviously he is like, you know, his knowledge, you know, his the spoken Urdu, and, you know, he... And his whole, you know, what he's not a Kannada, you know, he's not a Kannada, though he's in Kannada medium. Adiyanandre, udara Kannada Kannada huduga alla. Andre, namgellarigu anisadu yenappa ante idre, neevu bere yenakkadru ondannu kaliyakke hodaga, nimge ee Kannada panditrige iruva athava Kannada grammar bagge iruva ondu ontara ರಿಜಿಡ್ನೆಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನ ಕಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಬೇರೆ ಏನೋ ಪ್ರಯೋಗ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ನಾನು ಈ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್
ಮಡಿವಂತಿಕೆ
ಮಡಿವಂತಿಕೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಏನಾದರೂ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಇವರಿಗೆ ಒಂಥರ ತುಂಬಾ ತಮಾಷೆಯಾಗೂ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ಬೇಕು ಬೇಕಂತಾನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೀಟ್ಲಾಗಿ ಮಾಡೋಕೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು, ಮತ್ತೆ ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೊಂದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ಅವರೇ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಿದೆ ಅದು. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಮೊದಲಿಗೆ ಅವ್ರು, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಹೈಸ್ಕೂಲಲ್ಲೇ ಪದ್ಯ ಬರೆಯಕ್ಕೆ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದವರು ಅವರು. ಸೊ ಅಂಥದ್ದು ಏನೇನೋ ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ಅದು ಬಹಳ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಿ ಆ ಥರ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ ಅವರ ಭಾಷೆ ವಿಷಯದಲ್ಲಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ರ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯೂನು ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಅದು ಮಾತ್ರ ಅಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿ, ಅದು ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಟರಾಜ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗೇ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು, ದ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ದ ನವೋದಯ ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅದನ್ನೇ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗೋಲ್ಗೋತ ಬರೆಯೋದ್ರ ಮೂಲಕ ಗೋವಿಂದ ಪೈ ಹೇಗೆ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತನ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಸ್ಪಂದಿಸ್ತಾರೋ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ನಿಸಾರ್ ಅಹಮದ್ಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ತರದ ಧಾರ್ಮಿಕ ಅನುಭವಗಳಿಗೆ ಸ್ಪಂದಿಸೋದು ಸಹಜವಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಅವರು ಬೆಣ್ಣೆ ಕದ್ದ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ಲಿ ಹಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವ್ರೋಟ್ ಅ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಶಿಲುಬೆಗೇರಿದ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತ, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್. ಸೊ ಬಹುಶಃ ಗೊಲ್ಗೋತ ಬರೆದ ಗೋವಿಂದ ಪೈ ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಅದೇ ವಿಷಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಶಿಲುಬೆಗೇರಿದ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮತ್ತಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಗಂಭೀರವಾಗಿ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿರೋ ಒಂದು ಪೊಯೆಟಿಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಮತ್ತೆ ನಿಸಾರ್ ಅಹಮದಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಆ ತರನೂ ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ನಾವು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ.
ಅವರ ಭಾಷೆಯ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟಿವ್ನೆಸ್, ಅದರ ಹೊಸತನದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಮಾತಾಡಿದಾಗ ತುಂಬಾ ನನಗಿಷ್ಟವಾದ ಪದ್ಯ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಅಮ್ಮ ಆಚಾರ ಮತ್ತು ನಾನು, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಭಾಗ ಅಂತೂ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ಫುಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಮಿಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಯೂಬರೆನ್ಸ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಗ್ರಾಜುಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅ ಮೋರ್ ಸೀರಿಯಸ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಟ್ರೆಡಿಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಾಡರ್ನಿಟಿ. ನಟರಾಜ್, ಮೇ ಐ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ಟು ರೀಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇನ್ವೆಂಟಿವ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಅಮ್ಮ ಆಚಾರ ಮತ್ತು ನಾನು, which is probably one of his most popular poems, modernist poems.
Yeah,
Pallavi will then read us translation.
Yes. It's a much anthologized poem and a very popular poem, as you said. Also because it is self-critical, you know, of his own family and also his own culture. And also this poem, you know, brings out the kind of dramatic narrative that Nisar was capable of. As a reader of Nisar's poetry, I have always found Nisar to be, you know, a fine dramatic monologue writer whenever he wrote. I think that's where his excellence lies. I'll read from this poem. Ee padid valage Nisar ತನ್ನ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಯನ್ನ ಮಂಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಬಹಳ ತಮಾಷೆಯಾಗಿ ಮಂಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮದುವೆಗೆ ಮುಂಚೆ ಅಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ತಾರು ಹುಡುಗಿಯರು ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ ನಿಸಾರ್ಗೆ ಅಂತಲ್ಲ, ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ನೆರೇಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಸಿ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಿಸಾರ್ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ಇಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಮೈಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಯುನೋ ಜೋಸೆಫ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಇಸ್ಮಾಯಿಲ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿಬಡಿ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್. ನನ್ನ ಮದುವೆಗೆ ಮುಂಚೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ರೀಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪೋಯಮ್. ನನ್ನ ಮದುವೆಗೆ ಮುಂಚೆ, ನನ್ನ ಮದುವೆಗೆ ಮುಂಚೆ ಹತ್ತಾರು ಹೆಣ್ಣುಗಳ ನೋಡಿ ನಮ್ಮಮ್ಮ ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರನ್ನು ತನ್ನ ಒಪ್ಪಿಗೆಯ ಒರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅರೆದು ಅವಳು ಹಾಗೆ ಇವಳು ಹೀಗೆ ಆಕೆಗಿಂತವ ಸಿಕ್ಕಾಗೆ ಈಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸರಿಯಾದರೆ ಉದ್ದ ನಾಲಗೆ, ಒಬ್ಬಾಕೆ ಲಂಕಿಣಿ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬಾಕೆ ಜಿರಾಫಿನಿ, ಒಬ್ಬಳು ನಿಂತರೆ ಬೆದರು ಬೊಂಬಿಯ ತರಹ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬಳ ಹಲ್ಲು ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಬರಹ ಎಂದೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಹಚ್ಚಿ ಬಿರಿದು ಬಹಳ ದಿನ ಅವಿವಾಹಿತನಾಗಿಯೇ ಉಳಿದೆ. ಅಮ್ಮನನ್ನ ಮನಸಾರ ಹಳಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಅಮ್ಮ ಇವನ್ಗೆ ಹೆಣ್ಣು ಹುಡುಕ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾಳೆ, ಅವಳ ಆಯ್ಕೆಗಳೇ ಬೇರೆ ತರ ಇದೆ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅವಳು ಅವಳು ಅವಳಿಗೆ ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯಸ್ಥ ಹುಡುಗಿ ಬೇಕು. ಅಮ್ಮ ಕಟ್ಟ ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯಸ್ಥೆ. ಕುರಾನು ನಮಾಜು ರಂಜಾನಿನ ಉಪವಾಸ ಧಾರ್ಮಿಕ ಆಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳತೀರದ ಆಸ್ತೆ. ಬುರ್ಕಾ ತೊಡೆದ ಬೀದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾದು ಹೋಗುವ ನಮ್ಮವರ ಹೆಣ್ಣುಗಳ ಕಂಡು ಕಿಡಿಕಿಡಿಯಾಗಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಕಲಿತ ಬಜಾರಿಗಳ ಹಣೆಬರಹವೇ ಇಷ್ಟು. ದೇವರು ಧರ್ಮಗಳ ಭಯವಿರದೆ ಎಳ್ಳಷ್ಟು ಗಂಡಸರೆದುರು ಮೈ ಪ್ರದರ್ಶಿಸುವ ಗಂಡು ಬೀರಿಗಳು ಗಂಡಂದಿರ ಜೊತೆ ಬಾಳಿಯಾರೆ. ಇಂಥವರನ್ನ ನನ್ನ ಮಗನಿಗೆಂದು ತಾರೆ ಎಂದು ಪ್ರತಿಜ್ಞಿಸಿ, you know, that is a kind of experiment you would make. ಕಡೆಗೆ ಬುರ್ಕಾ ಹಾಕಿರುವ ಹುಡುಗಿನ ಮದುವೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ. It's a longish poem. I'll come to, you know, the last part of it. But the girl looked quite modern. ಒಂದು ದಿನ ಅಮ್ಮನಿಗೆ ಜ್ಞಾನೋದಯವಾಯಿತು ಎಂದೆನಿಸಿ ಊಟಕ್ಕೆ ಕುಳಿತಿದ್ದಾಗ, ನಿನ್ನಿಷ್ಟದಂತೆ ಓದಿದವಳನ್ನೇ ಮದುವೆಯಾಗಪ್ಪ ಎಂದಾಗ ಅಪನಂಬಿಕೆಯೊಂದಿಗೆ ಅಚ್ಚರಿಯೊಂದಿಗೆ ಖುಷಿಯೊಂದಿಗೆ ಭಯ ಬೆಳೆದು ಕೈ ತೊಳೆದು ಎದ್ದೆ ಬೇಗ. ಈಸ್ ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಟು ಮ್ಯಾರಿ ಎ ಗರ್ಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಚಾಯ್ಸ್. ನಾವು ಈ ಡಬಲ್ ಪದವೀಧರೆಯ ಭಾವಚಿತ್ರವನ್ನು ಇಡೀ ದಿನ ನೆಟ್ಟ ಕಣ್ಣು ತೂಗಿ ಅಳೆದು ವಿಳಾಸ ತಿಳಿದು ಹತ್ತಿರದಲ್ಲೇ ಕಂಡು ಮೆಚ್ಚಿ ನಿಶ್ಚಿತಾರ್ಥ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಮದುವೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮುಗಿಯಿತು. ಮನಸ್ಸು ಅಮ್ಮನಿಗೆ ಮೌನದಲ್ಲೇ ಕೈ ಮುಗಿಯಿತು. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಡ್ರಾಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಟರ್ನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಯಮ್. ಮೊದಲ ಸಲ ತಿರುಗಾಡಲು ಹೊರಟಾಗ ನನ್ನಾಕೆ ತೊಳಿಲ್ಲದ ರವಿಕೆಯುಟ್ಟು ಭಾರಿ ಸೀರೆಯನ್ನು ಸೊಂಟದ ಕೆಳಗೆ ನಾಜೂಕಾಗಿ ಕಟ್ಟಿ ಕಾಲಿಗೆ ಹೈಹೀಲ್ಡ್ ಕೆರ ಕೊರಳಿಗೆ ಚಿನ್ನದ ಸರ ಕಿವಿಗೆ ಬೆರಳಿಟ್ಟು ಉಂಗುರ ತೊಟ್ಟು ಲಿಪ್ಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಪೌಡರ್ ರೋಜು ಬಳಿದು ದೃಷ್ಟಿಪಟ್ಟಿಟ್ಟು ಹೆರಳ ಗೋಪುರದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂದಲು ಬಿಗಿದು ಎಡಬೈತಲೆ ತೆಗೆದು ಇವೆಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ಮೀರಿಸುವ ಮುಗುಳ್ನಗೆ ತೀಡಿ ಹೊಸಲು ಇನ್ನೇನು ದಾಟಬೇಕು ಆಗ ಬಂದೆ ತಡೀರಿ ಎಂದು ಒಳಗೋಡಿ ಬಂದು ನಡೀರಿ ಎಂದಾಗ ತಲೆ ಸುತ್ತಿ ನಾಲಗೆ ಬತ್ತಿ ನಾನಾದೆ ಮೂಕ ನೋಡಿದ್ದರೆ ನನ್ನವಳು ಹುಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಳು ನಮ್ಮಮ್ಮನ ಬುರ್ಖ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಮ್ಮ ವಿನ್ಸ್ ಏನೋ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯಾರೇಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಜಲ್ಡ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ದಿ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೈಟಲ್ಡ್ ಅಮ್ಮ ಆಚಾರ ಮತ್ತು ನಾನು. ಮೇ ಬಿ ವಿಲ್ ಯುನೋ ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ಪಲ್ಲವೀಸ್ English version now.
Okay. So this is the English version of it. Amma, tradition and I. Before I was married, mother checked out dozens of girls, ground each fine in the mortar of her approval, and handed out her considered verdicts. That one's like this, she said. This one's like that. I would take a crow over Miss A, and Miss J is fat. This one's fine, but her tongue is too long. That one's a giraffe. That Rakshasi is just wrong. This one's teeth are like a toddler's scrawl. That girl looks like a scarecrow overall. And thus she affixed each with a label. I remained single for years. Cursed mother envied my peers. Mother was a strict traditionalist. a believer, conservative ritualist. Quran and Burqa and the Ramzan fast were things she embraced, espoused to the last. But nothing riled her so much, truth be told, as our girls strolling burqa-less down the road. Look at them bearing their bodies, all bold and brassy. To all manner of men, it's downright unclassy. Not an iota of fear or respect for God or religion, but then what can you expect from a college girl? Such brazen shrews are not for my son. He deserves better, thank you. So she brought me black swathed bears who hadn't a clue of modern ideas or science or anything new. The kind that blindly trusted the village quack. Shuddering, I stepped back, begged to be allowed to choose my own bride, educated. But that flight of fantasy was speedily truncated. Education, shmeducation, what's the point of it? I never went to school. It hasn't hurt me a bit. See, a girl before marriage, that's against the rules. We didn't and thrived. Come, don't be a fool. Thus did mother summarily shut me up. Trusted, I turned to my trusty backup. Father was a liberal. Let the boy choose his own path. Amma cried flood of tears, cast aside food and water, and as per our fears, threatened death by water and fire. I shut up. It was all too dire. Father, man of the world, familiar with Amma's anger, her stubbornness, decided the fuss had reached the limit of reasonableness. Said, as you wish then, and withdrew into silence, cigarettes, late nights. He knew. It was out of his hands now. Sullen. He distanced himself from the villain. One day out of the blue, mother saw the light. At lunch, she said, oh, all right. You pick your educated girl and marry her. I will not put up a fight. Surprised, delighted, and awash with disbelief, I left the table suddenly nervous, heaving a huge sigh of relief. After gazing long and hard and evaluating the postgraduate's photograph, and locating her address, we meet face to face. Something ticks, and we are married, seemingly in two ticks. Silently, I send many grateful words, Amma words. Time now to step out of the house as a married couple. My beautiful spouse, dressed in grand sari, tied delicately below the waist, and sleeveless blouse, decked out in high-heeled shoes, rings at her ears and fingers, a string of gold around her neck, powder and lipstick, hair pulled up into a tired tower, very slick. And smiling a smile that put all of these in the shade, is about to step across the threshold when, oh, wait, she runs back inside and returns a moment later. Now I'm all set. I stare, struck dumb. The traitor is now looking very proper, very pakka. She's wearing my Amma's book.
Yeah. Thank you, Pallavi. This is a very this is a translation by Rupa Pai, and it has appeared in the magazine Scroll online. So it's a fun translation, as you can see. Basically, the poem talks about how his mother is very conservative and wants him to marry someone who wears a burqa and who's traditional in her ways. And she's very critical of girls who, you know, don't wear the burqa. And then I think a character who actually comes across as, there are just a couple of lines about Hisar's father at this point, you know. He's caught between this traditionalist wife and a son who wants to marry a modern woman. And, you know, he goes inside and starts smoking and brooding. You know, it's a minor character, but there's so much about, you know, how he has to cope with this. Eventually, he marries a modern girl. The woman, the mother agrees that he can go and find a modern, well-educated woman and well-educated bride, and then eventually towards the end he realizes that there's a bit of his mother and his wife and his wife and his mother. There's traditionalism in his wife, and his mom can be very modern and say, okay, go out and find a bride for yourself, you know. So I think this is a very interesting poem. And I think could we just look at another poem that's been very widely discussed and as widely anthologized as this one, which is Nimmoda Niddu Nimmantagade. Yeah. Would you like to read this, at least some parts of this poem, Ismail?
It's a short poem. It's not a very big poem. And I can read it fully, I believe. Nimmoda Niddu Nimmantagade. Nimmoda Niddu Nimmantagade. Jaggi. ಜಗ್ಗಿದ ಕಡೆ ಬಾಗದೆ ನಾನು ನಾನೇ ಆಗಿ ಈ ನೆಲದಲ್ಲೇ ಬೇರುತ್ತಿದ್ದರೂ ಬೀಗಿ ಪರಕೀಯನಾಗಿ ತಲೆಯ ತೂರಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಅದು ಬಲು ಕಷ್ಟದ ಕೆಲಸ ವೃತ್ತದಲ್ಲಿ ಉನ್ಮತ್ತರಾದ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕುಡಿತ ಕುಣಿತ ಕೂಟಗಳು ಕೆಣಕಿ ಎಸೆದಿದ್ದರೂ ಪಂಚೇಂದ್ರಿಯಕ್ಕೆ ಲಗಾಮು ಜಡಿದು ಜಾರದೆ ನಿಮ್ಮತ್ತ ಸಂಯಮವನ್ನೇ ಪೋಷಿಸಿ ಸಾಕುತ್ತಾ ರೇಖೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ದೊಂಬರಾಟ ನಡೆಸುತ್ತಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಅದು ಬಲು ಕಷ್ಟದ ಕೆಲಸ ಒಳಗೊಳಗೆ ಬೇರು ಕೊಯ್ದು ಲೋಕದೆದುರಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರು ಹೊಯ್ದು ನನ್ನ ಸಲಹುವ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕಪಟ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದರೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲದಂತೆ ನಟಿಸಿ ಚಕಾರವೆತ್ತದೆ ನಿಮ್ಮೊಡನೆ ಕಾಫಿ ಹೀರಿ ಪೇಪರ್ ಓದಿ ಹರಟಿ ಬಾಳ ತಳ್ಳುವುದಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಅದು ಬಲು ಕಷ್ಟದ ಕೆಲಸ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಾತುಕತೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಹುದುಗಿದ ಬೆಕ್ಕು ಸಂಶಯದ ಪಂಜವನೆತ್ತಿ ನನ್ನ ನಂಬಿಕೆ ನೀಯತ್ತು ಹಕ್ಕು ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಸಾಚತನವನ್ನು ಪರಚಿ ಒತ್ತಿ ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ನೀರು ತುಂಬಿದ್ದರೂ ಚೆಲ್ಲಿದ ರಕ್ತದಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯತೆಯ ಧಾತುಗಳ ನನ್ನೆದುರಲ್ಲೇ ತನಿಖೆ ಮಾಡುವ ಕ್ಷಣವನ್ನು ಉಸಿನಗುತ್ತಾ ಎದುರಿಸುವುದಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಬಲು ಕಷ್ಟದ ಕೆಲಸ
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಇಸ್ಮಾಯಿಲ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪೋಯಮ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ವೆರಿ ವೈಡ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಬೇಟೆಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೆಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ವೇರ್ ಹಿ ಸೇಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ಯು ಬಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ಂಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಸೊ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಡು ಯು ಸಿ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ ವೈ ಡು ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ so widely read and debated?
Yeah, because the thing is, you know, there are two things. I think most of the Nisar Ahmad poem never, you know, except this, you know, Amma Achara Mattu Nanu Rangoli Mattu Maga, and this poem, there are very, you know, very little number of poems which discusses this kind of issues. Maybe that is the one reason which is. And another thing is, this is written in around, you know, late 60s, I believe. So why he wrote is that, is another thing, but that is not important for me, but in how it sounds in my time is very important for me, and you know, it's very apt in this, you know, in this CAA and NIA and all this kind of times, it sounds very differently because it gives a different meaning altogether. But another interesting thing which happened after Nisar Ahmad passes away, so there is a discussion among social media about this poem, which is why he wrote this poem. So that is very interesting discussion in my view, because of that, you know, most of them who discuss that poem want to prove that, you know, he was not facing a problem with the current, you know, Muslims as a community are facing, but he was writing, he was intending something else with that poem, because he was responding to his contemporaries like Sumatindra Nadig, Lankesh, and so many others, how they were behaving with him. And, you know, this is the kind of, you know, all the people want to prove that, you know, the Muslims are facing problems only now, then it was not there. Nisar Ahmad was trying to write something else, and he was intent to, you know, say something else of his contemporaries. But the thing is, you know, why that whole discussion, what happened now on the social media is a kind of the politics which in a contemporary times are facing, and what the Muslims are really facing is that politics. So it is a kind of, you know, creating a new history, or, you know, even in the poetry they want to correct something. So that looks very strange for me now, but whatever the, and can't say that, you know Nisar Ahmad's experience is very different. Like, you know, he doesn't have an experience like whether it is Sara, Fakir, Bolwar, or anybody, because he doesn't have that kind of bitter experience except this one or two kind of things. Otherwise, as a Muslim, he didn't have got that bitter experiences like the next generation of his writers which had expressed. So that is another thing, because might be his social background might have given that advantage to him. That is one thing which I want to say that. And another thing is that, you know, this Rashtriyate thing, Chellida Raktadalli Rashtriyate Dhatugalannu Nedurale Tanike Maduva Kshanavannu Husi Naguta Edirisuvudidiyalla Adu Balu Kashtada Kelasa. I can draw one inference here that, you know, this comes, you know, it's in late 60s, you know, almost 69, or I don't know the year, so I think 69 or 66, I don't remember exactly. So that is the time when there were, you know, India is also fighting wars with China, and after that, you know, with, you know, many these kind of things were there, because you can see this with the Sanadi and as well as Akbar Ali. When there is a climate of war around, so suddenly these poets will become, you know, think about nationalism and the nationality more and more. I think all three, these three Muslim poets have faced in one or the other stage of their life this. So I think that expression came in Nisar Ahmed as well. This is what my observations are. Because I'm not a student of a literature, but I just, you know, as a journalist, what I can observe, which I observed that.
So the poem is actually talking about a sense of alienation, of being among people and yet feeling, you know, alone. And I think the background, and he's said this in conversations with some interviewers, again, as you said, it was a reaction to his close literary friends who used to be with him, hang out with him, but then would also mock him, you know, for writing what they thought was populist poetry. Now, this question is to Nataraj. How do you look at this? You know, he had two friends who would smoke and drink tea with him, and then they would you know, mock him and tease him and say that he writes poetry for the masses. How do you look at this poem, and what are your reactions to the reading that it was not really about the Hindu-Muslim question, but about this kind of mutual, you know, friendship? In today's lingo, it would be frenemies. How do you read this poem?
What Ismail tried to interpret, you know, this poem makes a lot of sense. And also the background of this poem, which the poet himself, you know, has many times shared with the, you know, those who interviewed him, makes this basically a literary dialogue, you know, sort of an answer, a reply, or a dig at his fellow poets, right? In fact, this poem, I think, came in the 70s, mid-70s or late 70s. I had also read it as a monologue of a writer who is upset with his fellow poets, because I also had a vague idea of the context in which the poet, the poem took shape. But, you know, as the readers grow, as, you know, sort of ideological readings were brought into, you know, reading poetry in the Kannada context also, this poem was read as a poem of alienation, because any good poem must always, as we all know, move from particular to the general. And the general idea of this poem, as Ismail repeatedly pointed out, was taken out. And especially this one, the kind of alienation each Muslim faces in this country, makes this poem, you know, very relevant today, especially because you are asking the minorities to prove their nationalism. You are asking the minorities to, you know, prove their patriotism. Definitely, it would definitely pick Nisar also in his times, because this problem began much before 1947, and it continued. And Nisar, being a, you know, poet, was responding to contemporary, you know, happenings, was surely responding to it, because in the first part of the poem, because the title itself has, you know, diverse suggestions that I'm different. I'm a different kind of a poet. I'm with you, Nadiga. I'm with you, Lankesh. I'm with you, some Adiga, but I'm something else. And also, there is this pang of pain that naan nim jothe idini adre ನೀವು ನನ್ನನ್ನು ಆ ಥರ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಭಾರತದ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಮರ ಒಂದು ಆಗೋನಿಯನ್ನ ಇದು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ನಿಜ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆವರಲ್ ಯುನೋ ಇಮೇಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋಯಮ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಕೀಪ್ಸ್ ರೆಕರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ನಿಸಾರ್ಸ್ ಯುನೋ ಪೋಯಮ್ಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿ ಮೆಟಫರ್ ಆಫ್ ಶಿಲ್ಬೆ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ಮಾಯಿಲ್ ವಾಸ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಯುನೋ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇನ್ ಶಿಲ್ಬೆಗೆ ಏರಿಸೋದು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಸವತಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಹಾಗೆ You know, why do you treat us like stepchildren? Savati makkala age namanna kaadabedi. And there are also, you know, poems where he addresses, the whole of India about the alienation of the minorities, especially this, line, Nimma matukategalalli hudugida bekku samshayada panjavetti nanna nambike niyattu hakku konege swachatanavannu parachi otti novige kannu tumbiddaru. So whatever discussion that's happening in social media to brand Nisar this or that, the poem might have been born in a particular context, but the poem grows out of context because the feelings expressed, the feelings of alienation expressed, feelings of humiliation expressed in this poem are really genuine. So definitely it echoes the alienation of a minority, for that matter, in the 21st century, even today in the era of Corona, where we see the kind of discourses, built against minorities, even for this, real pandemic.
Yeah, I think it's a poem that's been relevant for decades now, and I'm sure it will continue to be relevant because of its many resonances, many new meanings that it keeps acquiring. Pallavi, this question is to you. You have been active in the anti-CAA protests, and you have also been singing at these protests. I think the poem that you sung that it files is Hum Dekhenge. Is there anything about Nisar's poetry that would lend itself to this kind of protest? I mean, do you see any protest poetry of this kind in the poetry of Nisar Ahmed?
I mean, two of his poems come to my mind. One of his poems I sing regularly in my concerts, but I've also been singing this, Nataraj or Hail Sankene. Kurigadu Sad has been relevant ever since it was written. And even now, even in the CAA protests and NRC protests, I sang Kurigadu, which also felt very, very, relevant and meaningful, the way that it kind of fits into the narrative today. And Nada Devi Kandini Namadalli Antadrishya, even that poem kind of is also talking about the disparities that, so obviously are right now in this time, the times of Corona and the pandemic, the kind of disparity that we see in our country. We knew it was there, but the way that it has kind of just, it's right in front of us in, say, cinema scope. I don't know, how do you say, like, you just cannot look away from it. It's there and we have to acknowledge it. And this poem that he's written, Nada Deviye Kande Ninna Madilalli Yantha Drishya Nobu Nageya Samishra Dalli Yadeyayi Tadake Vashya. ಒಂದೆದೆಯ ಹಾಲ ಕುಡಿದವರ ನಡುವೆ ಕೇಳಿದ ತಾಯಿ ಒಂದೆ ನೆಲದ ರಸ ಹೀರಲೆಂದು. ಯಾ, ಶುಡ್ ಐ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಬೋತ್ ಕುರಿಗಳು ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಡದೇವಿ? ಅ ಫ್ಯೂ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್.
ಯಾ, ವಿ ಕುಡ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಕುರಿಗಳು ಅ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಲೇಟರ್, ಬಟ್ ಮೇಬಿ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಕಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನಾಡದೇವಿ.
ಓಕೆ, ಯೆಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನಿತ್ಯೋತ್ಸವ ಆಲ್ಬಮ್. ಸೋ ಬಿನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ fantastic that they had like a not just one kind of poem, but different kinds of poems in the Nityotsava album also. So this is by Mysore Ananthaswamy. Nada Deviye Kande Ninna Madilalli Yantha Drishya Novu Nageya Sammishradalli Edeyayi Tadakke Vashya ಒಂದೆದೆಯ ಹಾಲ ಕುಡಿದವರ ನಡುವೆ ಎನಿತೊಂದು ಭೇದ ತಾಯಿ ಒಂದೆ ನೆಲದ ರಸ ಹೀರಲೇನು ಸಿಹಿ ಕಹಿಯ ರುಚಿಯ ಕಾಯಿ ನಾಡದೇವಿಯೇ ಕಂಡೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಮಡಿಲಲ್ಲಿ ಎಂಥ ದೃಶ್ಯ ನೋವು ನಗೆಯ ಸಮ್ಮಿಶ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಎದೆಯಾಯಿತದಕ್ಕೆ ವಶ್ಯ
ಅನ್ನವಿರದ ಹಸುಳಿಗಳ ತಬ್ಬಿ ಅಳುತ್ತಿರುವ ತಾಯ ಕಂಡೇ ದುಃಖ ಪೂರ ಉಕ್ಕುಕ್ಕಿ ಮೊರೆಗೆ ಕೊಚ್ಚಿತ್ತು ಬಾಳ ತಂಡೆ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆ ಹೇಳಿಗೆಯ ಬಿಚ್ಚಿ ಹಸಿದ ಹಾವನ್ನು ಚುಚ್ಚಿ ಕೆಣಕಿ ಯುಕ್ತರಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಣಿಸಿ ದಣಿಸಿ ನಲಿದಿಹರು ಹಲರು ಬದುಕಿ ಯುಕ್ತರಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಣಿಸಿ ದಣಿಸಿ ನಲಿದಿಹರು ಹಲರು ಬದುಕಿ ನಾಡದೇವಿಗೆ ಕಂಡೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಮಡಿಲಲ್ಲಿ ಎಂಥ ದೃಶ್ಯ ನೋವು ನಗೆಯ ಸಮ್ಮಿಶ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಎದೆಯಾಯಿತದಕ್ಕೆ ವಶ್ಯ ನರನನ್ನೇ ಗಾಳವಾಗಿಸುತ್ತ ಬಾಳ ನೀರಲ್ಲಿ ನಲಿವನರಿಗೆ ನಾವೊಂದು ಎನ್ನುವ ಸತ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಅಡ್ಡಗಾಲೆಳೆವ ನಾಡನರಿಗೆ ಎಚ್ಚರವ ನೀಡಿ ತಿದ್ದುತ್ತಲಿರಲಿ ಕವಿ ಭಾವವೆಂಬ ಬಡಿಗೆ ತಾಯಿ ಭಾರತಿಯೇ ಇದುವೆ ನಿನಗೆ ನಾ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಲಿರುವ ಕೊಡುಗೆ ತಾಯಿ ಭಾರತಿಯೇ ಇದುವೆ ನಿನಗೆ ನಾ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಲಿರುವ ಕೊಡುಗೆ ನಾಡದೇವಿಗೆ ಕಂಡೆ ನಿನ್ನ ಮಡಿಲಲ್ಲಿ ಎಂಥ ದೃಶ್ಯ ನೋವು ನಗೆಯ ಸಮ್ಮಿಶ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಎದೆಯಾಯಿತದಕ್ಕೆ ವಶ್ಯ
The fact that, you know, he says to be critical of what I see in my land itself is my in times of the CA and NRC protests, I think it really resonates with the times.
Thank you, Pallavi. Those who cannot read Kannada, I think there are publications that might help them read Nisar's poetry. There's an anthology edited by Dr. C.N. Ramachandran and published by the Manipal University Press. And now, as we know, Rupa Pai has been translating his poems. We could now move on to Nisar Ahmad's contribution to this genre that is now called Sugama Sangeeta. I think when it all began, it was still called Bhavagite. You know, I think the name caught on a little later. So this album was recorded in 1978. That's when cassettes were ruling the roost, and it was a pioneering album in many ways. And it had poems by Nisar Ahmad, and as we all know, the title song Nityotsava became an anthem for Karnataka, an unofficial anthem, and it was sung widely, you know, at schools and colleges. And then again, it had a mix of styles. You had the ghazal like, Mattade Besara Ade Sanjay Ade Ekanta, which you sing so well. And there were Haridasa kind of compositions, Benne Karda Namma Krishna. We will ask Pallavi about this album and the songs in the album. But before that, this question is to Ismail. Ismail, how do you look at the poems in this album? I mean, how do you react to the poems, the kind of variety, the diversity that Nisar was able to achieve in a span of maybe 60 minutes, you saw several styles that he could attempt and, excel at.
Yeah, the thing is, Nisar, that's very interesting because I've interviewed him 4 times and in once I've asked a question about this Nityotsava. He wrote this poem in Bangalore, in fact. So he came for a vacation to Bangalore in November, it is. So, All India Radio asked him to write a poem for this, the special program on Kannada Rajyotsava. So then he said, he was thinking about that, what to write. Then suddenly he remembers he came from Shivamogga. And he remembers this yoga and then he writes this poem. Buddhi Deepad Badakale Barde Nanu, he said the same thing. So he wrote and... because I don't know the because I can't say anything about this because Nataraj is the best person to say, because you know why the Navya poets were against this, you know, which is lyrical, any poem which is lyrical. So they have a kind of the hatred towards the lyrical thing, any poem which is lyrical. You can see with the writings of Ramchandra Sharma or Lankesh or anybody, you know, I think they've coined a particular title called cassette kavigalu. So how it comes, because you know what is, why they were hated towards this lyrical poems, I don't know. Really, I don't understand that, because since Nataraj can answer, because he knows all these poets like Lankesh as well as Ramchandra Sharma knows very closely, and he also studied this Navya poets very closely, because though the Lankesh has took a different way up from the Navya school, and why they have got that hatredness towards this, because Lankesh also wrote a kind of poems like, you know, Elide Elitanka Elinda Bandeva and all that, and but he's, and many times he's also criticized this cassette kaviguru.
Yeah, Nataraj, this question, I think that's an interesting observation. I think Nisar Ahmed and many other poets were sort of caught in this controversy, and there many people thought that this whole movement was moving towards populism rather than but then the song form itself is as old as the hills, and it was a popular form with all the great poets. Kuvempu wrote songs, Bendre wrote songs, Adigar wrote songs, although he later came to be associated more with modernist poetry. What was it that made this movement? What was the criticism against the song form, that the Sugama Sangeeta form that actually exploded after Nityotsava became such a sensational hit?
See, the Navya poets, in fact, redefined their poetics, and as I perhaps mentioned in the beginning, they defined their, you know, poetry as felt thought. In Nisar itself, you see this very strange split in this creative personality. Look at the, you know, poems which Pallavi sang. There is this Nityotsava, you know, lyric which eulogizes, Karnataka, and at the same time, the other poem which Pallavi placed before us, Nada Deviye Kandeninna Madilalli Entha Drushya. There is, self-criticism. If you juxtapose these two poems, you will understand Nisar. Yes. See, Lankesh and Sharma, they were against the lyrical, because there was a tendency by them to write, not lyrics, but songs for the cassettes. So that's why they were called cassette kavis, kavigalu, matte dasa kavigalu, anta kariyodikke shuru madidru. But there is an anecdote, I think it happened. And after the, kind of popularity which Nityotsava saw in Karnataka, even Gopal Krishna Adiga, I think, anecdote that Gopal Krishna Adiga, in fact, asked Ananta Swami, Mysore Anand Swami, to make a cassette of his, which Anand Swami did. Kendavare anta madidarala. Actually, Adiga also started as you rightly pointed out, as a poet who wrote lyrics, Pallavi has sung that song, Yava Mohana Murali Karito, Alindane Adiguru Shuru Madidru. Adre, somehow our poetics change aitu, Nisar Ahmed's poetics change aitu. But Nisar is a case of, literary history to be studied, because he switched over to this, if not populist mode, popular mode, because he wanted to reach. But this is a catch-22 situation for a poet. If you want to, create another Nityotsava, even for Nisar, it was not possible, because by then a new trend in Karnataka had emerged already, Bandaya literature and Dalit literature, which would not approve this kind of poetry. So this is also a problem of, this is also a tussle between different, kinds of poetics. But at the same time, if I go further and try to understand the split in Nisar, Nisar was also drawn to Sahir Ludhianvi kind of lyrics when he wrote Fir Wahi Raat kind of Mata De Besara Bardrala. I think I have the English version also, Mata De Sanje Ade Besara. The English version is the Sumne Nanim Turstini. And the same boredom again, the same boredom again, the same evening and the same solitude. Without your company, without any talk, my mind is forlorn. So this forlornness is different from the kind of forlornness or alienation which we saw in Nimoda Niddu Nimmantagade. Because you know, this, there is a price which a poet has to pay when he becomes, you know, popular. I think Nisar had to pay that price because Nisar had become a public personality from being a private poet by 80s. He was on a greater demand, and there were demands of the readers, and the dictatorship of the readers is terrific for a poet. Kavige, he ಓದುಗರ ಸರ್ವಾಧಿಕಾರ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಬಹಳ ಭಯಂಕರವಾದದ್ದು ಅವರ ಡಿಮಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಬಹಳ ಭಯಂಕರವಾದದ್ದು ಯು ಕುಡ್ ಸಿ ಲೇಟರ್ ಭಾವಾಂತರಂಗ ಅಂತ ಬರೆದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಕೆಲವು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮುಂದೇನು ಅವರು ಭಾವಗೀತೆಗಳನ್ನ ಬರೆದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಅಷ್ಟೊತ್ತಿಗಾಗಲೇ ನಿಸಾರ್ ಅವರ ಏನೋ ಕಾವ್ಯ ಒಂದು ರೀತಿ ಡೈಲ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು ಆದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಅವರ ಲಿರಿಕ್ ಇಂದ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯುನೋ ಕ್ಲೇಮಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲಿರಿಕ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ It perhaps happened because he was caught between two different kinds of poetics, different modes of writing, the lyrical mode and the introspective mode. That is where he had to strike a balance, because in Adiga, the split in Mohana Murali continues to Bhumi Geeta also, continues to Chintamani Alli Kandamukha also, which did not happen in Nisar Ahmad. So Nisar Ahmad was already a ganya poet. ಅದು ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ರು ನಿಸಾರ್ ಅಹಮದ್. ನಿಸಾರ್ ಅಹಮದ್ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀರಲ್ಲ, ಬಹಳ ಓಲ್ಡೆಸ್ಟ್, ಬಹಳ ಸೂಟ್ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ನೀಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅಷ್ಟೊತ್ತಿಗಾಗಲೇ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕವಿಯ ಮಾನ್ಯತೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಈ ಕುವೆಂಪುಗೂ ಹಾಗಾಗತ್ತೆ, ಬೇಂದ್ರೆಗೂ ಹಾಗಾಯ್ತು, ನಿಸಾರ್ಗೂ ಹಾಗಾಯ್ತು. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಟ್ ಏನೋ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ, ಯಾವುದು ಆ ರೀತಿಯ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ ಕವಿಯಾಗಿ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈಸಿ ಟು ಗೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಟ್ರಾಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೋಯಮ್ಸ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ರಿಯಲಿ. ಪರ್ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಟು ಯುನೋ ನಿಸಾರ್ ಅಹಮದ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಿಸಾರ್. ಆದರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ನಿಸಾರ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಯುನೋ ದಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್. ಮುಂದೆ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರಕವಿ ಯಾರಾಗಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನುವ ಯುನೋ debate bandaga, when there was a debate around who should be the Rashtrakavi in Karnataka after GSS, Nisar was picked to be the Rashtrakavi for some time, and later the government withdrew the very post itself, post or runner, whatever it is called, withdrew. And Nisar, in fact, I spoke to him by then he was really disappointed, because he expressed he presented the kind of secularism which we all love, the kind of secularism which we all stand by, and Nisar stood for those values. Nisar stood for the kind of humanitarian, broad humanitarian values which we all would say for. Nisar's poetry might have been diluted later, but the kind of message that Nisar's poetry has is one of broader kind of humanism and secular. So I think Nisar will have a place in Kannada poetry. If Nisar is not a major poet in Kannada literary history, he would definitely be a very significant poet and a very good lyricist Kannada modern poetry.
Yeah. So you find that his later poetry was affected by this trend towards a certain populism, or at least in his attempts to write poetry that was popular, that because he moved closer to the song form than to the modernist form that made him so well known earlier. Pallavi, I think Nataraj started by talking about this very popular song, Mattade Sanjay Ade Besara. If you could sing a couple of lines from this, a very beautiful song, and then maybe you could look at Kurigalu Sar and we could discuss how actually, while it might have had its problems, it was the album itself was pioneering, path-breaking in many ways. If you could start with Mattade, the ghazal-like song that you sing so well.
Yes. I think Nisar Ahmed had, like you said, he was very, he wanted to write the ghazal format in Kannada and bring that format to the Kannada music world. And apparently he also suggested to Mysore Ananthaswamy that, you know, that he should compose it in such a way. And this is that very, very close to the Fir Wahi Gham Wahi Tanhaiya.
Mat de be sara ade sanje ade ekanta mat de be sara ade sanje ade ekanta ninna jyoti illade matillade mana vibhanta mattade besara ade sanje ade ekanta kannane danisuva ಪಡುವಣ ಬಾನ್ ಬಣ್ಣಗಳು ಮಣ್ಣನೆ ಹೊನ್ನಿನ ಹಣ್ಣಾಗಿಸುವಿ ಕಿರಣಗಳು ಕಣ್ಣನೆ ದಣಿಸುವ ಈ ಪಡುವಣ ಬಾನ್ ಬಣ್ಣಗಳು ಮಣ್ಣನೆ ಹೊನ್ನಿನ ಹಣ್ಣಾಗಿಸುವಿ ಕಿರಣಗಳು ಹಚ್ಚನೆ ಹಸುರಿಗೆ ಹಸಿಡುತ್ತಿರುವಿ ಖಗಗಾನ ಚಿನ್ನ ನೀನಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಬಿಮ್ಮೆನ್ನುತ್ತಿದೆ ರಮ್ಯೋಧ್ಯಾನ ಮತ್ತದೆ ಬೇಸರ ಅದೆ ಸಂಜೆ ಅದೆ ಏಕಾಂತ ನಿನ್ನ ಜೊತೆಗಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಮಾತಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಮನ ವಿಭ್ರಾಂತ ಮತ್ತದೆ ಬೇಸರ ಅದೆ ಸಂಜೆ
Thank you so much. While this is very close to the ghazal form, you know, the more romantic form that the Bhavagita was initially associated with, the album Nityotsava also had this particularly striking song, Kurigalu Sar Kurigalu, which is you know, which compares our citizenry to sheep and our leaders, the politicians, to butchers, and it's a sort of satirical poem. And it was not written in the form of a song. It was like any of his modern poems, modernist poems. And then Mysore Ananthaswamy's, I think it's Mysore Ananthaswamy's genius that actually turned it into a song. And Nisar has also gone on record to say how indebted he is to Mysore Ananthaswamy for making many of his poems so popular. Would you sing this song? And also consider the question, why more of such experiments did not take place? Why didn't composers, for example, take more modernist poems and try to set them to music? Why did they always look for poems that were set to meter ಒಂದು ಛಂದಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಜಪ್ತಾಲ್ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ದಾದ್ರಾನಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಡುವಂತ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ಸ್, ತಾಳಕ್ಕೆ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುವಂತ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಹುಡುಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಭಾವಗೀತೆಗಳು ಯಾಕೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಮತ್ತೆ ಕುರಿಗಳು ಸಾರ್, ಕುರಿಗಳು ಅಷ್ಟು ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಮುಟ್ಟದಂತ ಒಂದು ಮಾಡರ್ನಿಸ್ಟ್ ಪೋಯಮ್, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡರ್ನಿಸಂ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸಂಗೀತ ಎರಡೂ ಸೇರಿ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಹೊಸ ಸೌಂಡ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಿವಿಗೆ ಬಿತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಯಾಕೆ ಮುಂದುವರಿಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡ್ಬೋದಾ?
ಎಸ್, ನಾನು ಅದು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಹಾಡ್ ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್, ದ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ಹೌ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ fresh it is even today in terms of as a composition. And neev heldange ondu gapadyada reetiyalli, it's not written in the form of a lyric, and really the genius of Mysore Anantha Swami has turned it into a not only a song that you know can be sung, but also a song that has a certain tempo and a certain, you know, is falls into a certain rhythmic pattern. So adin hartini, and then we can discuss the question that you put for. Kurigalu sa kurigalu kurigalu sa kurigalu sagitte kurigalu mandeyali vandagi swantateye bandagi adara bala idu idara bala adu adara bala idu ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದರ ಬಾಲ ಅದು ಮೂಸಿ ದನಿ ಕುಗ್ಗಿಸಿ ತಲೆ ತಗ್ಗಿಸಿ ಅಂಡಲೆಯುವ ನಾವು ನೀವು ಕುರಿಗಳು ಸಾ ಕುರಿಗಳು ಎಡ ದಿಕ್ಕಿಗೆ ಒಬಲ ದಿಕ್ಕಿಗೆ ಒಮ್ಮೆ ದಿಕ್ಕು ಪಾಲಾಗಿ ಎಡ ದಿಕ್ಕಿಗೆ ಒಬಲ ದಿಕ್ಕಿಗೆ ಒಮ್ಮೆ ದಿಕ್ಕು ಪಾಲಾಗಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಹೇಗೋ ಹೇಗುತ್ತಿರುವ ಬರೀ ಕಿರುಚಿ ರೇಗುತ್ತಿರುವ ತಿನ್ನದಿದ್ದರೂ ತೇಗುತ್ತಿರುವ ನೊಣ ಕೂತರು ಬಾಗುತ್ತಿರುವ ಹಿಂದೆ ಬಂದರೆ ಒದೆಯದ ಮುಂದೆ ಬಂದರೆ ಹಾಯದ ನಾವು ನೀವು ಅವರು ಇವರು ಕುರಿಗಳು ಸಾ ಕುರಿಗಳು ಹೊಸ ಕುರಿಗಳು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಯುವ ಕುರುಬರು ಕುರುಬರು ಹಕ್ಕುರುಬರು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಯುವ ಕುರುಬರು ಶಾನುಭೋಗ ಗೀ ಚಿತ್ತಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಬ್ಬೆಟ್ಟನ್ನು ಒತ್ತುವವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಯುವ ಕುರುಬರು ಜಮಾಬಂದಿ ಗಮಲ್ದಾರ ಬರಲು ನಮ್ಮಳೊಬ್ಬನ ಮೆಚ್ಚಿ ಮಸೀದ ಮಚ್ಚ ಹಿರಿದು ಕದ್ದಗ ಛಕ್ಕೆಂದು ಕೊಚ್ಚಿ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿಯ ಮೆಹರ್ಬಾನಿಯ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿಯ ಮೆಹರ್ಬಾನಿಯ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೈಯ ಜೋಡಿಸುತ್ತ ಕಿಸೆಗೆ ಹಸಿರು ನೋಟ ತುರುಕಿ ನುಡಿಗೆ ಬೆಣ್ಣೆ ಹಚ್ಚುವವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಯುವ ಕುರುಬರು 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 ಬಿಸಿಲಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ದೂಡಿ ಮರದಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ತಾವು ಕೂತು ಬಿಸಿಲಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ದೂಡಿ ಮರದಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ತಾವು ಕೂತು ಮಾತು 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 ಮಾತಿನ ಗೈರತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲೇ ಕರ್ರ ಮತ್ತು ನಡೆಸುವವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಯುವ ಕುರುಬರು ಕುರುಬರು ಹೆಕ್ಕುರುಬರು ನಮ್ಮ ಮೈಯ ತುಪ್ಪಟವ ರವಷ್ಟು ಬಿಡದ ಹಾಗೆ ಸವರಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮೈಯ ತುಪ್ಪಟವ ರವಷ್ಟು ಬಿಡದ ಹಾಗೆ ಸವರಿ ಕಂಬಳಿಗಳ ನೇಯುವಂಥ ಯೋಜನೆಗಳ ಹಾಕುವವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಯುವ ಕುರುಬರು ಕುರುಬರು ಹೆಕ್ಕುರುಬರು ತಳಬೂರಿದ ಕುರುಬ ಕಟುಕನಾದ ತಳಬೂರಿದ ಕುರುಬ ಕಟುಕನಾದ ಅವನ ಮಜ್ಜಿಗ ಏನು ಹೊಳಪು ಏನು ಜಾದು ಏನು ಮೋಹ ಕಣ್ಣು ಕುಕ್ಕಿ ಸೊಕ್ಕಿರುವ ಕತ್ತನದಕ್ಕೆ ತಿಕ್ಕಿರುವ ಹೋಗಿ ಹೋಗಿ ನಕ್ಕಿರುವ ನಾವು ನೀವು ಅವರು ಇವರು ಕುರಿಗಳು ಸಾ ಕುರಿಗಳು ಹೊಸ ಕುರಿಗಳು ಒನಾ ಕುರಿಗಳು
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಪಲ್ಲವಿ, ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್. ವೈ ಡು ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಪೋಯಮ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಸಾಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ನೋ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್? I mean, we've heard of hip hop and we've seen all kinds of experiments happening where you take the musical element is pushed a little to the background and then poems are recited, you know, on a rhythm. Why didn't this take off in Kannada? Why are we so fond of the Bhavagita form as it was in the time of Nityotsava. Why didn't Nityotsava take us to prod us to experiment further?
I think a lot of experiments happened earlier than later in terms of composition, in terms of choice of poems. I'm also extremely disappointed when I've heard so many composers and so many Sugama Sangeeta practitioners say that, oh, this poem we can't sing because, you know, it's not in a certain meter, it's not falling into the 4-beat or the 8-beat or, you know, the more a form becomes popular, the more restricted it gets, and the more formatted it gets, and people stop taking risks, people stop thinking about new ways of expressing, people stop looking for new kinds of whether it is expression or imagery or chandas or all this. So this has, I also think that, Sugama Sangeeta should have been more adventurous and should have engaged more with even the non, whatever you say, the non-lyrical poetry of Kannada. But Karunal Babelake Musuki Deem Abhinali is not, you would not think that it could be sung. But when it is sung, it feels like it is quite a, beautifully set to a rhythm or a melody. I think these experiments should have happened more. I can only say that I wish it had happened and it should happen. Like I said, it became very popular, Sugama Sangeeta. And I don't know, the focus of Sugama Sangeeta itself needs to be questioned again. The core value, the core need to sing Sugama Sangeeta needs to be questioned time and again, because it cannot be to sing, something that is a popular idea of Sugama Sangeeta, not a nostalgic idea of Sugama Sangeeta, but something that explores the poetry of the time, and that somewhere has also, I also think as a Sugama Sangeeta practitioner, that has kind of lost its way, and we need to find it again, or maybe relook and reimagine ways of singing poetry.
Thank you, Pallavi. Yes, I think these are insightful observations. You worked with two of the three great Sugama Sangeeta composers. If you had to think of a trinity for Sugama Sangeeta, it would probably be Kalinga Rao, Mysuranand Swami, and Ashwath, who were the most prolific. Of course, there's a galaxy of composers out there. You have personally worked with two of them, Ashwath and Anand Swami. So, and you have personal stories to tell, I'm sure, about how they approached this whole idea of composing for contemporary Kannada poetry. Before we come back and talk a little bit more about this, I would request Nataraj for his comments on how music, how rendering of poetry can be more, can become more exciting, and what is the, how do you go? Pallavi has been talking about how singers and composers and Sugama Sangeeta artists have to be more adventurous. What is the pathway? How do you see this? What is the way forward?
Complimenting the anchor is not a good practice, but I compliment you because you have already started this experiment in your Vachana band, trying to experiment. I think the Bhavagita form, which is in our mind, you've also made me write songs. We did, a cassette in 1980s when we were in college, when we were in
university. You're guilty of two songs.
Yeah, you are the one who brought me to the lyrical mode once again, the age of lyric, and I had no qualms writing, poems. But now, very recently, I was to write two or three songs for one of my you know, screenplays which is still on. And somehow, you know, the writers, especially those who try to write these songs, have a model already in the mind, as Pallavi was trying to bring out. That's where the writer, maybe we have to break. Lankesh, I think, broke it, which Ismail was pointing out in when he wrote songs for Anurupa and Elindalo Bandavaro. He, you know, he broke this mold. You know, he wrote, poems as he would write a modern poem. And the problem is also with the composers who would not take a, bold step in experimenting with the poems as Anand Swami did, which Pallavi was singing. Because the beauty of that poem, you know, though it is slightly anti-democratic, this poem is anti-democratic, which my friend Pattabhiram Somayaji once analyzed in a literary magazine. Then I found out, yes, because this has, two types of the shepherd and the sheep. But when Nisar wrote this poem, it was an era of, great social justice in Karnataka. The Gopal Gowda era, was there in 70s, till 70s, and Basulingappa had emerged, and, Devarajarsu had emerged, and Devarajarsu had brought in tremendous change in the life of, poor people of Karnataka with his Busudharana and land reformation and all. And, the poem looked slightly cynical also, but the beauty of the poem is in that, expression, sir. Kurigalu, sir, I think it struck the note, I suppose. And also the way, Mysore Anand Swami experimented with it, though he was a disciple of Kaling Rao, he, picked this, poem. I think that tradition should have, been continued with others also, which Hamsalekha took up later. Hamsalekha, tried to break the mold in both his, composing songs, and also, in his musical, compositions. So I think the onus is also on the music directors who could pick up, songs which cannot be easily sung, which may not have the kind of rhythm which you expect to sing. I think singers will have to take a, bold step here, and also the writers, the poets, may have to lead from here. So I think Nisar successfully experimented with both, and he tried to, be lyrical, and also he tried to be colloquial in his, other poems.
Ismail, ee sugama sangeeta anno form, ee yeradu cinema sangeeta ond kade innond kade shastriya sangeetada nadave iruvanta ond vaya media anta nodabodeno. Neevu, you are a big music buff, neevu hasanadalli matte mattond kade ella neevu haadugalannu kelidid bagge helta iddi. Nimge nityotsavada bagge adra the Nisar Ahmad avara maadidanta matte Mysore Anand Swami avara jothe seri maadidanta ondu putta revolution bagge nimge alli heng kandittu
illa andre naavu kelostuttigagle enagittu antidre manegalalli cassette al kelidvi matte adu hard kelovaga avaga idre idi politics artha aagtirilla hard chenagide anta kelidvi aste adu ondu matte nortta hodaga actually ಪಲ್ಲವಿ ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ದು ಕೊನೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿದ ಒಂದು ಮಾತು ತುಂಬಾ ಬಹಳ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್, ಅದು ಕನ್ನಡದ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತು ಭಾರತದ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಆಗ್ಲೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತೇನು ಒಂಥರ ಅದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ನ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಗೆ ಬಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಮತ್ತೊಂದ್ ಕಡೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದೊಂಥರ ತನ್ನ ಟ್ರೆಡಿಷನಲ್ ಪಾತಲ್ಲೇ ಹೋಗಿ ಅದೆಲ್ಲೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗಂಟ ಕೊಳುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ನೀವು ಟಿ ಎಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪ್ರಯೋಗಗಳು ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾರ್ದೇ ಪ್ರಯೋಗಗಳು ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಅದು ಕೊನೆಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾ, ನೀವು ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆ ಅದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ವಚನ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗಲೂ ವಚನ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಿ, ಕನ್ನಡ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ. ಅಥವಾ ಕನ್ನಡ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಹೊರಟ್ರೆ ಅದಷ್ಟು ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಆಗಿರಲ್ಲ. ಇದು ಒಂಥರ ಇದು ಯಾಕಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನನ್ಗೆ ಭಾರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ನಿಸ್ತು. ಆ ದೃಷ್ಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಕುರಿಗಳು ತರದ ಪದ್ಯನ ಮೈಸೂರನ್ನ ಸ್ವಾಮಿಯವರು ತಗೊಂಡು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇರೋ ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಪ್ಯಾಕೇಜ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅದು ನಂಗೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾಕೆಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಕ್ಯಾಸೆಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಕಡೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಪ್ರತಿ ಆರ್ಕೆಸ್ಟ್ರಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತಿ ಗಣಪತಿ ಉತ್ಸವದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುರಿಗಳು ಸರ್ ಕುರಿಗಳು ತರದ ಒಂದು ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಹಾಡು ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದೇ ಇತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ದಾಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮಿ. ಸೊ ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗಳಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಟೇಪ್ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡರ್ ಬರಕ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಲೇಟ್ ಆಯ್ತು. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹಾಡ್ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊತಾ ಇದ್ದಂಗಿದ್ರೆ ಯಾರ್ದೋ ಮದುವೆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು, ಅದ್ ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಈ ತರ ಆರ್ಕೆಸ್ಟ್ರಾಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಥ ಲೈವ್ ಹಾಡುಗಳು ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ಯಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ನನ್ಗೆ ಮೋರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ನಿಸ್ತು. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎರಡನೇದು, ನಾವು ಇಡೀ ಈ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಈ ತರದ ಇಸ್ಥೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡುವಾಗ, ಅದು ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡುವಾಗ ಒಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ನ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದೊಂದು ಬೇರೆ ತರ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಯೋಗ ನಡೀತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದನ್ನ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ದಲಿತ ಸಂಘರ್ಷ ಸಮಿತಿ ರೈತ ಸಂಘದವರೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ ಹಾಡುಗಳ ಬೇರೆ ತರ ಹಾಡಿದ್ರು.
ಎಸ್,
ಸುಗಮ ಸಂಗೀತ ಬಿಟ್ರು, ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರೀಯ ಸಂಗೀತ ಬಿಟ್ರು, ಸಿನಿಮಾ ಸಂಗೀತ ಬಿಟ್ರು, ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸಲ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಹಾಡು ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ರು. ಅದನ್ನ ನಾನು ಫೋಕೋ ಅಂತಾನು ಹೇಳಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ಒಂದು ಅದಷ್ಟು ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ಇದಿಷ್ಟೇ ನನ್ನ ಸಂದೇಶ.
ಹಾಗೆ ನೋಡಕ್ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಸಿದ್ಲಿಂಗಯ್ಯಸ್ ಪೋಟ್ರಿ ಲೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ವೇಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಯಾ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ಲಿ ರೈಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ಂಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಎನಫ್. ಅಂಡ್ there are translations that Nisaram had attempted. He translated Neruda and he translated two Shakespeare plays, Othello and Midsummer Night's Dream, and these were staged in the 70s quite frequently. And you know, that was a time when all the many great playwrights were active. I think Karnad was active, his plays were being staged, and Nisar, I think Lankesh, Karnad, and Kambar, and you know, his plays contended with the plays of the best at you know, of the best writers of the time, and he also translated Neruda. So would you have any quick comments about his translations, Nataraj?
Yeah, Nisar should be credited with this, that he was the first one to, you know, bring out a collection of Neruda's poems in Kannada, introducing Neruda. So that is where we understand the diverse interests Nisar had, bringing Neruda into, you know, Kannada in the early 80s is quite an interesting event. And then in Othello and Midsummer's Night's Dream, Nisar is best whenever there are lyrical, you know, passages. His lyrical intensity has come to the fore whenever he translated such parts in Midsummer Night's Dream and Othello. But to the credit of, you know, Nisar, that he was able to engage with the political poetry of Neruda and the lyrical intensity of Midsummer Night's Dream and tragedy like Othello. This is where, you know, I feel Nisar, you know, had tremendous possibilities which were made use of by creative Nisar. And later, perhaps, when he started writing the kind of prose he started writing, I think he deviated. He should have stuck to poetry. He should have stuck to the plays. He could have stuck to, you know, his, you know, Kurigulu Sar, Kurigulu kind of poetry. And also, nobody has used sarcasm and irony, which is as striking as Nisar. That was his forte. Somehow, when he wrote his prose, which was so rhetorical, he lost this. And Nisar, somehow, post Kurigulu Sar, Kurigulu, and post Nimodonidu Nimantagade, started responding to the contemporary events, you know. He was shy of it. He had his own reasons, because it was not easy for, you know, minority intellectual to express his views in public, you know, especially in the 90s. That also made Nisar sad. When he spoke to me for the last time, perhaps 3-4 months ago, I could see he was sad at the kind of, you know, events that were happening. And he was very happy when he saw something very healthy in a paper, in a newspaper column, and he would call me. And the last, before he kept his phone, he said, Chanagirappa, God bless you, Kanappa. These are the last words of Nisar. Thank you.
Thank you, Natraj. Ismail, any concluding remarks?
Yeah, one thing I want
we
to say.
We will conclude with the song by Pallavi, because music again is a great way to conclude anything.
I would like to say about his translation of Othello, which is very interesting translation for me, it is at least. You know, the way he wrote the dialogues of Iago. It's not about the Othello, it's about the Iago. Iago, finally he comes and says, "Nin yak madde nan gottilla ante helo nanga exact a dialogue bodu nan gottilla ante helodu est lyrical agide antandre nanga Iago ontara ayyo sum sumne hingella madbidnalla appa ante bejar agost agutte nanare pade pade matmat oddaglu aa Iago n character hanga kaado hange adun translate madidara avaru so adantara adana Othello n avaru thumba astondu idagtaru matte ನಿಸಾರ್ಗೆ ಏನಿತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅವರ ಕಂಟೆಂಪ್ರರೀಸ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಒಂಥರ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಲಿಟ್ರೇಚರ್ ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದವರು ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನನಗೆ ಎಜ್ರಾ ಪೌಂಡ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ವಾ, ನನಗೆ ಎಲಿಯಟ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ವಾ, ಅವ್ರಿಗಿಂತ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ವಾ ಈ ಥರದ್ದು. ನನ್ನ ಎರಡು ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂ ಅವ್ರು ಅದನ್ನ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಏ, ನಾನು ಲಂಕೇಶ್ಗಿಂತ ಮೊದಲೇ ಎಜ್ರಾ ಪೌಂಡ್ ಓದಿದ್ದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಕ್ಕೆ, ಅಥವಾ ನಾನು ಅದು ಇದನ್ನು ಓದಿದ್ದೆ ಅಂತ. ಈ ಥರದ್ದೊಂದು ಒಂಥರ ಒಂದು ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಅವರು ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯನ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ.
ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ Sorry, if you had to name three of his greatest works, what would they be? Which ones would they be?
Oh, obviously, Svajanodharakaru anta ardun padya ide. Mostly adana hechinavaru yaru mention madala. It's again comes from the same Muslim sensibility and everything in nam Kannada literary iduk parivara. Nanga avara translation alli andre jaasti translation illa, but Midsummer Night Dreams gita Othello nanage thumba ishta. ಪದ್ಯಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅಗೇನ್ ಆಗ್ಲೇ ನಾವು ಮೂರ್ನಾಲ್ಕು ಪದ್ಯದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಆ ಪದ್ಯಗಳೇ ಇದು. ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವರ ಅಚ್ಚುಮೆಚ್ಚು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋ ಅವರ ಗದ್ಯ ಸಂಕಲನ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ನನಗೇನು ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಗಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದೊಂದೇ ನನಗೆ ಅವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಇರುವ ಸಿಟ್ಟು ಕೂಡ. ಅವರು ಪೊಯೆಟ್ರಿಗೆ ಲಿಮಿಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದಿತ್ತು ಅಂತ ನಟರಾಜ್ ಹೇಳಿರೋದನ್ನ, ಅಥವಾ ಅವರ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೋಸ್ಗೆ ಲಿಮಿಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದಿತ್ತು ಅಂತ ನಟರಾಜ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ನ ನಾನು ಒಪ್ತೀನಿ.
ಫಾರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಟಿವ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್, there's a reader edited by the well-known journalist G.N. Ranganath Rao, Nisar Vachike, I think, which has a representative collection of his Nisar's works. And of course, he wrote, I think, 14 volumes of poetry, and then his output is very prolific. Natraj, quickly, which are the three works that we should remember and that are your favorites?
Definitely his... ಅರ್ಲಿ ಪೊಯಿಟ್ರಿ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಮನಸ್ಸು ಗಾಂಧಿ ಬಜಾರು, ನಿಮ್ಮೊಡನಿದ್ದು, ನಿಮ್ಮಂತಾಗದೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಔಟ್ ಒನ್ ಪೊಯಮ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಅಮೆರಿಕಾ ಅಮೆರಿಕಾ.
ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಅರ್ಲಿ ಪೊಯಿಟ್ರಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಸಂಜಯ್ ಐದರಮಳಿ, ಹೀಸ್ ಅ ಗಾಂಧಿ ಬಜಾರ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇನ್ ಮೆನಿ ವೇಸ್. He's spoken about the bustle of Gandhi Bazaar, and there's a very fond poem about Masti, which is, I think, one of my favorites. We will go on to Pallavi, ask her for her choice of the three great works of Nisar Ahmad, and then maybe conclude with a song. Thank you, Natraj. Thank you, Ismail. And thank you, Pallavi, for this very insightful discussion. And we should also, we are also grateful to Bangalore International Center Toto Funds the Arts for giving us this opportunity to discuss Nisar Ahmad. Thank you so much. Pallavi, three of your choices, and then let's conclude with a song. Your favorite, what you like best about Nisar?
Of course, Kurigaru sir, I kind of sing it everywhere that I go. That is a poem that really is close to me, and Matta De Besara, which is extremely beautifully written and also beautifully composed. And if one more I have to I'm of course talking only about his poems and the ones that I sing, not even the ones that I've. If I have to single out one more, then maybe Yella Marethiruvaga, Yella Sallada, Nevava, Hoodi Paradirumate, Hale and Enepe. That is another beautiful poem. So should I sing that and
sure.
end? Yeah.
Yella Marethiruvaga, Yella Sallada, Nevava, Hoodi Paradirumate. ಹಳೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಲ್ಲಿನಂದದಿ ಬಿತ್ತು ತಿಳಿಯಾದ ಎದೆ ಕೊಳವ ರಾಡಿಗೊಳಿಸುವೆ ಏಕೆ ಮಧುರ ನೆನಪೇ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮರೆತಿರುವಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸಲ್ಲದ ನೆವವ ಹೂಡಿ ಬರದಿರು ಮತ್ತೆ ಹಳೆಯ ನೆನಪಿ ಕಪ್ಪು ಕಣ್ಣಿನ ನೆಟ್ಟ ನೋಟದರೆ ಚಣವನ್ನೇ ತೊಟ್ಟು ಬಾಣದ ಹಾಗೆ ಬರದಿರು ನೆನಪೆ ಬಿರಿದ ತುಟಿಗಳ ತುಂಬು ನಗೆಯ ಕಾರಣವನ್ನೇ ಹಿರಿದು ಕೊಲ್ಲಲು ಬಳಿಗೆ ಸಾರದಿರು ನೆನಪಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮರೆತಿರುವಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸಲ್ಲದ ನೆವವ ಹೂಡಿ ಬರದಿರು ಮತ್ತೆ ಹಳೆಯ ನೆನಪಿ ಸತ್ತಭೂತವನೆತ್ತಿ ಹತ್ತಿನಂದದಿ ಬಂದು ಸತ್ತಭೂತವನೆತ್ತಿ ಹತ್ತಿನಂದದಿ ತಂದು ನನ್ನ ಮನದಂಗಳಕ್ಕೆ ಹಾಕದಿರು ನೆನಪೆ ಭವ್ಯ ಭವಿತವ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಮೊಗ ಮಾಡಿ ನಿಂತಿರುವೆ ಬೆನ್ನಲ್ಲೇ ಇರಿಯದಿರು ಓ ಚನ್ನ ನೆನಪಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮರೆತಿರುವಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸಲ್ಲದ ನೆವವ ಹೂಡಿ ಬರದಿರು ಮತ್ತೆ ಹಳೆಯ ನೆನಪಿ
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಪಲ್ಲವಿ and thanks Nataraj, Ismail and Pallavi for this wonderful tribute to one of our most remarkable poets, K.S. Nisar Ahmad, 1936-2020. Thank you so much.